life sometimes got me on my knees. I've been praying for redemption, learned my lessons. My pain is my therapy. Cutting all ties, won't you baptize me? Set me free.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a Ford 1972 Ranchero. This is a great car in good condition, not even a scratch on it. I am back on the streets, ladies and gentlemen. I am at work getting ready to load this car. So today, we are going to talk about the truth of baptism. So as soon as I put this car on the rack, we gonna talk. See you after the intro. Guys doing? So today we're going to talk about baptism. I'm going to tell you why we're going to talk about baptism. Because I got that text right there. I got that comment. And I got a couple of them. I'm going to show them to you later. But in this one right here, it says, "You are wrong about Catholics being baptized." Okay, this ain't one of those videos to set the record straight or nothing like that. This is to educate the believers. You know, Jesus says in Matthew chapter 24, and I think it's verse 3. Well, it's really verse 4. The disciples asked him a question. And it was asking him, when would his return be? You know, when shall these signs be, and when shall be the end of the world? Because they knew the world was going to end one day. So they was asking for Jesus to tell them, you know, to ask them. They was asking Jesus for a sign before he comes, so they'll know. The first thing that Christ said before he got into, you know, there will be many saying that I am Christ and I am he, and before he get into the earthquakes and the pestilence and all that, the very first thing, his very first answer was in verse 4 of Matthew chapter 24. After they asked him that question in Matthew chapter 24, verse 3, he turned around in verse 4, and the very first thing he said was, take heed. that no man deceive you. In other words, don't let nobody deceive you. Don't let nobody trick you. Don't let nobody fool you. He says to be careful of that. We, brothers and sisters, we have to be careful not to be tricked of the enemy, which is the devil. We have to be careful of that. So today we're going to talk about the truth of baptism. And we're going to be coming out of this book. See this book right here? This is the Holy Bible. This is God's word. The word of God is the instructions of our life. Everything that God wants us to do is in this book. Everything that you need to know is in this book. That's why we call it basic instructions before leaving earth. Basic instructions. This is the instruction. This is your instruction manual. So if you want to know how to please God, read this book. If you want to know the ways of God, read this book. Don't let no preacher, no teacher, no bishop, no reverend, no priest, no father, no pope, nobody, not even me, tell you that God said he wants us to do it this way, and I don't show you, I don't take you in here to show you what he said. That's why I always put scriptures up. Always. I'm doing it today. I'm always doing it. Unless I'm just having a conversation with you guys about something. But anytime I say God said this or God said that, I take you to the word. Because the word is our final authority. We need to know what the word of God says about every situation in our life. Don't let this person teach you something and it ain't from God. Because he could be teaching you his ways and not God's ways. Amen. So that's what we're going to learn today. The truth about baptism. You see in the beginning of the in my intro, you see that guy was getting baptized. And I said in my last video, I was talking about people, some people got offended because I said about how this person thinks that because you baptize your 2-month-old and the man sprinkled with the water, that that's baptism. We're gonna find out today, is that the baptism of man? Or is that the baptism of God? That's what we're going to talk about today. So the person hit me up and said, you are wrong about Catholics being baptized. Okay, well, we're going to see today if I'm wrong. First of all, let's look at what the word baptism means. Let's look at that word. Let's look at Google. I'm going to put it up there for you, but don't take my word for it. Because I could have typed that up, right? Don't take my word for it. I'm going to show you. But after this video, you go on Google yourself and you Google these words. Go on Google and look at the definition of baptized. I put it up right there. Look what it says. I put it at the top. You see at the top, this is what I Google. I said, what does it mean to be baptized? It says the word baptism comes from a Greek word, baptize, which means to immerse. The word baptize means to immerse. It says baptism is a ceremony in which Christians is immersed in water before the church to publicly symbolize, because baptism is just a symbolization. It's just a symbol. It says to symbolize their belief in Christ. Because baptism is a symbol of the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ. Amen. We're going to get to that in a little bit. Hey, listen, let me explain something to you. This is a very good study that we're about to talk to. So don't change the channel. If you're a Christian, if you're a believer, and you really want to understand the truth about baptism, we're going to talk about this for a while. I don't know how long this video is going to be. But if you're really hungry for that word, I advise you to sit down, walk with me through the scriptures and walk with me through the definition, and let us learn today the truth about baptism, because there's a lot of false stuff out there and we don't want to get caught up in doing something that is not right in the eyes of God. Frank said this is the way to do it. Bob said this is the way to do it. This person said this is the way to do it. I don't want to do that. I want to do it the way God's doing it. I don't want you doing it the way I do it. I want you to do it the way God said do it, because that's what I got this channel for, not to tell you what Joe the Street Preacher say. I got this channel to tell you what God says, what thus says the Lord in Old Testament used to say. Amen? Let's look back at that. It said the word baptism comes from the Greek word baptize, which means to immerse. The word baptize means to immerse. Well, Joe, that word is not my everyday vocabulary. I don't know what the word immerse means. Okay, so we're going to look it up. Look it up right there. Immerse. It says, look at number one. It says dip or submerge in liquid. Immerse the paper in water for 20 minutes. Take that paper and immerse. In other words, you dip it. You dunk it. I was telling my wife about this earlier when I was breaking this down to her. A lot of times I talk about stuff with my wife before I actually do it on video. But, you know, it remind me of when me and my wife is at home and we're laying in the bed and we watch the TV and we want to eat some Oreo cookies or chocolate chip cookies, and we either going to have cocoa or coffee or we're going to have some milk. When I get the cookie, I take my Oreo cookies. I don't take waters and sprinkle on the cookie and eat it. I take the cookie. Don't we all do that? We take the cookie and we do what? We dip it into the cup so that it would get soaked. So it would go in the cup so it would get drenched of the water. And then we bring it out and eat it. That's what it's saying here. The word immerse says to dip or submerge in liquid. It's to dip, like we take the cookies and dip it in the coffee, or we take it and we dip it in the milk. Well, that's the same way we are. We have to be dipped into something, not sprinkle on, but dipped into something, because the true definition of the word baptize is not to be sprinkled on. The definition is, the correct definition is to be immersed. And what is immersed? To be dipped, right? It says, or submerge in liquid. Look at the word submerge. Right there. The word submerge. There you go, right there. It says, cause to be underwater. Submerge means to cause to be under water. Just like the video we saw in the beginning. But did they sprinkle water on that man? No. They did it the correct way. How do I know it did it the correct way? Because that's what the Bible says. The Bible says that baptized means to be submerged, to go under the water, to be dipped into the water. The man in the beginning of the video, they held him and they brought him down into the water and then brought him back up. Look what it says, submerged. Caused to be underwater. It's like a houses had been flooded and cars submerged. You know, when a lot of rain comes, when that rain is flooded and it get deep, it goes over the cars. They're telling you that car is submerged under the water. That car has submerged. The houses have submerged under that water. That's what a submerged means. Those are just synonyms of the word baptized. They're just giving you a definition of what the word baptized means. When you go and tell somebody that you've been baptized, you are actually telling them that I went under the water. I was dipped into the water. I went down and came back up. Not that I've been sprinkled on. That's not the right way to do that. It is nowhere in scripture. I don't know who came up with that foolishness. But that's not Bible. That's not Bible. That's what I'm trying to teach you guys on here. That's not Bible. I've been studying this word, and I don't say I know it all. I'm never going to say I know it all. I know a lot because I spent a lot of time in this word right here, right? And I asked God to teach me. I didn't want to go to seminar school, because see, that's what they teach in seminar school. You could go sprinkle some water on them, that's baptized. Or you go baptize a little two-month-old, that's okay. No, it's not okay. We're going to get into that too. That's irrelevant to do that. You're wasting time. And if you paid money to get that done, you wasted your money, because that's not counted. He's 2 months. She's 2 months. We're going to get into that. But anyway, so let's go back. So the word baptism comes from a Greek word, baptize, which means to immerse, to be submerged, to go under the water. That's what the word baptize means. Baptism is a ceremony in which Christian is immersed in water, which is dunked in water, which goes down in water. That's what it say, right? That's what the definition say. I ain't seen nothing. First of all, we talking about this definition, and then now we're going to get into the word. But I just want to let you know what the definition is. How can you been sprinkled with water go out and tell people you've been baptized? How you been baptized? You ain't went under the water. You've been sprinkled on with water. You ain't went under the water. You can either love me or hate me, because I'll be here to tell you the truth. What I always tell you guys, I'm going to keep it what? 100. I can't sit here and make y'all believe in a lie. People lying out here. People are deceiving out here. People are leading you in their own way. My job is to teach you God's way. And how do you know it's God's way? Because I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you in the book. I'm going to show you what the book says, not what Father Jack says or Father Frank says or this priest or that pope or this person or that reverend. No, I want to teach you what God says. Amen. So the true definition of the word baptize is to be immersed, to be submerged, to go underwater, to be dipped in, not sprinkled on. So let's go to some Bible examples. Let's see how people were baptized in the Bible. Let's see if they were sprinkled on or if they went in the water, under the water. Let's see that. Look at Matthew chapter 3. Look at this. This was John. Now you heard of John the Baptist, right? You know why they call him John the Baptist? That wasn't his religion. He wasn't a Baptist. Or a Pentecostal, or a Presbyterian, or a Lutheran, or a Catholic, or none of that. They called him John the Baptist because he was baptizing people. That was his job. He was bringing people, putting people under the water, baptizing them in the name of the Lord. Look at this. It says, in those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness. That's what he was doing. He was preaching in the wilderness. He was in the wilderness by a river called, and the river was called the Jordan. It was the Jordan River. He was inside of the river, of course, in the shallow end. And people, he was preaching, and people from all over was coming because he was out there preaching. God drew all these people out there. And as he was preaching the word of God, people heard the word of God. People got convicted of their sins, and this is the repentance, and they want to get right. They want to go now and confess their sins to God, and they want to go get baptized. They want to be clean. This is just a symbolize of being clean. Amen. He says, in those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness of Judea. Preaching in the wilderness of Judea. And saying, look what he was saying. Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. He is preaching. And he is telling his audience. He is telling the people that are out there that are listening to him. The first word come out of his mouth is repent. Why? Because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is coming, but you got to repent first. You got to turn away from your sin. You got to acknowledge that you're a sinner. You got to regret that you sinned, and you got to be willing to make it right with God. You got to confess your sins to God and be willing to turn away from that. The purpose of going into that water to get baptized is because you are publicly telling people that I standing here today, I'm going to die. This old man is going to die. I'm going to be buried in this water. When I come back up, this is resurrection. This means I'm a new person. I ain't that cusser no more. I ain't a thief no more. I ain't gonna fornicate no more. I'm gonna be working on these things by the power of God, because I'm telling everybody through these actions that I am about to change my life. I am serious about this message I heard. I want to turn away from sin. I want to be dead to that to that old life. That's what baptism is. Don't go to church and get baptized playing. Be serious. Don't go because everybody else going. Don't go because your cousin going. Because your cousin may be serious, but you ain't serious. You'll go up there and get baptized, but you still going to go to the club this week. You still going to drink. You still going to smoke. You still going to fornicate. That ain't serious. You got to have a made up mind. I'm tired. I don't want to live this life no more. I've been sinning. I know my life ain't right. I want to get right with God. I'm done. I'm going to go to church. I'm going to hear the word. And then I'm going to go get baptized. And that's it. I may struggle from time to time. I may slip and fall. But I ain't going to willfully go and sin. I ain't going to willfully go to the bar and go drink and get drunk. I know I ain't supposed to do that. You got to have a made up mind before you go get baptized. Anyway, that's why he says repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So he says, Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Verse 5. Then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan, and was baptized of him in the Jordan, confessing their sins. These people were baptized of John. Okay, well, how did John baptize them? Did he stand out there sprinkling water on them? No, we learned what the word baptize means. The word baptize means to be submerged under the water, to be immersed in water. That's what these people was doing. This is our example. If you want to make sure that you're doing it right with God, follow the example. Basic instructions. Follow the book. You can't go wrong. You can't go wrong if you follow the book. He got examples in here on how people got baptized. Look. He says, verse 6, and were baptized of him in Jordan. And what were they doing? They was confessing their sins. Lord, forgive me. I lied. I've been a liar. I've been a fornicator. I've been a thief. I done cheated on my husband. I done cheated on my wife. I done stole. I done robbed. I done murdered. I done whatever your sin is. This is the moment when you realize that your life ain't right, but you want to make it right with God. So you're going to confess your sins. You're going to do what God tells you. You're going to go ahead and get baptized, and not sprinkle on. You're going to go get immersed, submerged on the water. Look at the next one, verse 13. Look at this. This is a good example. You know, if you say you're a Christian, that means you're a follower of Christ, meaning that what Christ do, you do. What he did, you suppose that did. Look at verse 13. Look what it says at the top now. It says, baptism of Christ. It says, then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan unto John to what? To be baptized of him. Jesus showed up on the scene. And the reason why he showed up is to be baptized of John. Jesus himself wants to be baptized. He's given us an example that even he himself is going to be baptized. He's going to be baptized. He's not going to be sprinkled on. He's going to be baptized, which means submerged under the water. Verse 14, but John forbade him, saying, I have need to be baptized of thee, and camest thou unto me. In other words, John was very humble, and he knew who this was. He knew this was the Lord. And he said, I'm going to baptize you. I should be baptized by you, not be baptizing you. And look what Jesus says. And Jesus answered, said unto him, suffer it to be so for now. In other words, suffer means like allow. In other words, all right, just allow it to happen for now. He said, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him. He allowed him. Look at verse 16. Look at this. Pay attention to this now. This is baptism. This is our example. We already seen that John the Baptist was baptizing people in the Jordan River. Baptized mean that they were being submerged in the water. They wasn't being sprinkled on. They were being submerged. They went down in the water like the guy in the video, in the intro. Now look at Jesus. Verse 16, and Jesus, when he was baptized, meaning that when he was submerged, when he went down, went up straightway out of the water. Wait, hold on. He went up immediately out of the water. So he was baptized, which means that he went down in the water. And then after he went down, he immediately came up, just like the guy in the video in the beginning. You go down, you come up. You don't stay down there no 2-3 minutes. You don't need to do that. You just a dip, like you dip your cookie in your milk, or your cookie in your hot cocoa or whatever. You just go down and come up. That's what Jesus did. Those are the perfect example. If you got a preacher talking, oh yeah, be down there at least 5 minutes. No. That ain't what Jesus did. The Bible said when he went down, when he was baptized, he immediately, that's what straightway means. He immediately came back up. Verse 16 again. And Jesus, when he was baptized, when he was submerged under the water, went up straightway, right away, out of the water. And lo, the heavens were opened unto him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lightened upon him. But what I'm trying to show you in this is our example. The Bible is our example. These scriptures are our example. If you want to know how to get baptized, read your Bible. Stop following this person and that person and this person because they got on these little collars. They got these titles, father this and pope this and priest this and reverend this and bishop this and preacher this and this and that. Stop following these titles. Follow Christ. Follow the word of God. And I'm going to show you why you need to follow the word of God at the end. You can never be wrong if you follow the word of God. And Jesus, verse 16 again. And Jesus, when he was baptized, when he was submerged under the water, went up straightway, went up immediately out of the water. So he was down in the water and immediately he came back up out of the water. Amen. He was baptized. The people in the Jordan went under the water. Jesus himself went up under the water. We'll give you some more examples, biblical examples. I ain't giving you examples of what this person said or that person said, because that's irrelevant. This is what's relevant. This is what's important. The word of God. Verse 35. We're in Acts chapter 8. Look at verse 35. Then Philip, these are the apostles. This is the time when Jesus, now he went on the cross, he died. The third day he arose, he appeared to the disciples and so many other people. And then after that, he was taken up in the cloud and he went up to the heaven. Now they are to preach the gospel. They are to do the very same things. They've been walking with him for 3.5 years. They've been taught by him for 3.5 years. Now they are to go forth and to go preach the gospels about the things of Christ. Amen. So they're imitating what they saw Christ do. Verse 35, then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture and preached unto him Jesus. Philip was preaching to these people. He was preaching to this guy about Jesus. Verse 36, and as they went on their way, they came unto a certain water. And the eunuch said, see, here is water. What do it hinder me to be baptized? So this man, if you watch the movie of Jesus, this man that was in the chariot. I think he was wealthy. He was a eunuch. And Philip, which was an apostle, was preaching to him about Christ. And after he heard all these things about Christ, as they was there, he turned around and he saw the river. He saw the water. And look what he's saying in verse 36. And as they went on their way, they came unto a certain water. And the eunuch said, see, here's water. What do it hinder me to be baptized? What does the word baptized mean? To be submerged underwater. He said, what's stopping me from going in that water, to go get dunked in that water? What's stopping me from doing that? Verse 37. And Philip said, if thou believest with all your heart, you mayest. And he answered and said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I'm gonna stop right there. That is important. The man saying, what is this? What's to stop me? What's to hinder me from getting baptized, from going over there in that water and going down and then coming up, like the proper way to do it? What's to hinder me from that? Look what Philip's answer was. This is the proper way before you get baptized. And Philip said, verse 37, and Philip said, if you believe with all your heart, you may. If you believe what? He tell you down at the bottom. Because the man confessed, said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Baptism for people who believe in God, who believe in the Son of God, which is Jesus. You're being baptized. You have to believe that he came. You have to believe that he's the Son of God. You have to believe that he died. And on the third day, he was resurrected and he's up there at the throne of God. You have to believe that before you get baptized. Tell me, how in the world can a two-month-old... How can a two-month-old believe that? How can a two-month-old even understand that? The one that's getting sprinkled on by the water. How can he even understand that to go get baptized? Explain to me, normally people that are getting baptized is people that has lived a life of sin and they've come to this point in their life that they realize that they have sinned. They want to make it right with God. They no longer want to be the old man no more. They want to be a new man in Christ. So now they confess their sins and they're going to get baptized. What two-month-old needs to go get baptized? What sins he confessing? What sins is he confessing? He been lying? Is he a thief? Is he fornicating? Is that two-month-old married and he cheating on his wife? Or that two-month-old married and she cheating on her husband? What sin is she doing? Joe, you know, we all became sinners when we came. No. We were all born into sin. Children, babies are innocent. That's why when a baby died, they immediately go to heaven. Immediately. Immediately go to heaven. If you have a mother and a father, and both of them sinners, don't believe in God, but they have a baby, and they get into a car accident, that baby going to heaven. And according to the word of God, unbelievers will have their part in the lake of fire. Mom and daddy going down there to hell. I know a lot of people don't like when I talk like this, but this is the truth. We need to know the truth. We need to understand the truth. We need to stop living a life that nobody goes to hell. We all go to heaven. We got to stop that, because that's not the truth. That's not the truth. You keep stick with us on this channel, you're going to learn the truth. As days go on, we're going to get into that. But that's not the truth. I'm telling you, that's not the truth. That's why Jesus said there's a wide road that leads to destruction. He said there's many that is on that road. But he said there's a narrow road that leads to eternal life. And he says only a few. Out of all the billions of people down here on this earth, it's only a few. It's going to be millions, but it's only going to be a few compared to all the other people that's going to make it into heaven. Why? Jesus says in Matthew chapter 7, it's telling you about judgment day. And people are going to come to him and say, Lord, 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 have I not did this and did that? He's going to say, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. Workers of iniquity mean that you lived a life of sin without repentance. And because you choose to live a life of sin, your sin has separated you from God. So there's no relationship between you and your God, because you can't stop drinking, you can't stop cussing, you can't stop fornicating, you can't stop doing these things that you're learning not to do. You keep choosing to go down that path. God intervenes in your life. He'll send somebody to try to tell you this is the wrong way. You get mad at that person, cuss that person. Now you mad at that person. You talking down on that person, but you don't understand God is the one that sent that person to you. He's trying to help you, but you keep rejecting the help. So you keep going down that path. Yeah, you go to church on Sunday, but you're sinning all week, purposely, willfully, without conviction, without repentance. You think because you go up there on Sunday and bow your head when the preacher praying, you think you're good for the rest of the week. This is a day-to-day thing. We have to live right every day. Yes, we're going to make mistakes. Yes, we're going to do things that's wrong. As soon as you acknowledge it, God, forgive me. I'm sorry. Help me not to do that again. Amen. A 2-month-old, 3-month-old, 1-year-old, 2-year-old. Waste your time baptizing. What you baptizing them for? They're too young to believe in Christ. Don't even know. You're talking about, do they know who the Son of God is? They don't even know who you are yet at 2 months. They staring at you, don't know you mama or daddy. They don't know how they came into this world. They still trying to grasp life. They're still trying to understand what's going on at 2 months. They don't know nothing about a creator, and he had a son, and 2,000 years ago he died, and he preached to God. They don't know nothing about that. They barely know who you are. They see you keep being in their faith. Goo-goo-ga-ga-ga. They try to figure out what's wrong with this person, with this goo-goo-ga-ga. What that mean? You know what I'm saying? They don't understand anything. They're not going to understand about the creator and his son, and Jesus died for our sins. They don't understand sin. They don't understand what's right or what's wrong yet. They ain't cussing. They ain't stealing. They ain't lying at no 2-3 months, 4 months, 5 months. All these people going to get their kid baptized because they think when they get them sprinkled with that water that it washed away their sin. What sin? They ain't sin yet. They innocent. Jesus says after he spoke to a person, he said after that they have no excuse for their sin. When somebody come to you and tell you, hey man, you know smoking is wrong or cussing is wrong, that's the Lord using that person to tell you. After you hear that and you still continue to do it, it's sin. But a 2-month-old, 3-month-old, does that make sense to you? A 2-month-old, he's not a sinner. He was born in sin, but he's still innocent in the eyes of God because he ain't doing no wrong. So, Philip, verse 37, and Philip said, if thou believest with all thy heart, if you believe with all your heart, you mayest. You want to get baptized, you first got to believe with all your heart. And what do you got to believe? He confessing now to Philip the thing that he got to believe. He answered and said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. To be able to be baptized, to be able to be immersed, submerged under that water, you must first believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. You cannot be a Muslim believing that Jesus is just a prophet and call yourself going to get baptized. That's confusion. You're not baptized because you got to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, not that he's a prophet. Verse 38. And he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they went down. Look at that. They went down. He didn't go somewhere and they say they sprinkled. No, he went down. He was just talking about that water earlier. Remember? He was just talking about that water earlier. Now what it says in verse 38. And he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they went down both into the water. Philip, the one got to dunk him in there. And they went down both into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him. What's the definition of the word baptized? He submerged him underwater. He just like that guy in the video. Just like the guy in the video. He went down, and he immediately, like Jesus did, he immediately came back up. Verse 39. And when they were come up out of the water. Okay, so verse 38 say, and they went down. See that? Verse 38. And he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they went down into the water, and he was baptized, meaning that he was submerged. Verse 39 tell you, and when they were come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught him away. So he went down, and then he came up out of the water, just like Jesus did. That's the same way they did in the days of John the Baptist. That's the same way you saw in the beginning of the video. Ain't nobody being sprinkled by nothing and call themselves just got baptized. That don't even make sense. That don't even make sense. The definition of baptized is to be submerged underwater. Okay,
so look what Peter, the disciple, said. He had gathered up all these people. All these people was around him. He was preaching. A lot of people that was in this crowd. This was right after Christ was crucified and died. You remember when Christ was on the cross, there was people screaming out there, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" They was talking about Christ. They wanted the murderer to be let out and to put Jesus on death row. They wanted Jesus to be crucified, and Jesus didn't do no wrong. He didn't do no sin. They didn't like him preaching the truth. You know, when you preach the truth, people don't like when you tell the truth. They don't. They don't. I know that by experience. I've been battling with that for years. But anyway. Verse 36, therefore, he's telling these people that was out there crucifying, these people that didn't believe that he was the Son of God, that didn't believe that he was the Messiah, he's letting them know. He said, therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God had made that same Jesus whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart. You know, it cut them. You know, you never heard that the truth hurts? Well, they was being told the truth, and it hurt them because they was convicted of their own actions, because these were some of the people that was out there screaming, crucify him. These were the people that didn't believe, but when they heard this message this day, they was convicted of it. And look what they said. And said unto Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Now they didn't heard the word of God. Now they want to make it right. They want to make it right with God. They realized that they sinned, that they made a mistake, and they want to make it right with God. So they asked the apostles, what shall we do? Verse 38, then Peter said unto them, repent and be what? Baptized, meaning be submerged under the water. Every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. He's letting them know that you have to repent. You have to be sorry for your sins. You have to realize that you have sinned against God. A 2-month-old ain't sinned against God. He cannot be sorry for his sins. He's 2 months. He's 3 months. So he has nothing to repent of. He ain't did nothing wrong. How many lies he told in 2 months? Do he lust after women at 2 months? Does she lust after men at 2 months? Have he stole something from somebody at 2 months? No. Is he fornicating? No. Does he smoke? No. Does he drink? No. Does he cuss people out? No. Is he hating somebody? Do he hate somebody? Has somebody did something to him at 2 months and he's unforgiving? No. Little kids are not like that. They're very unforgiving, especially when they're truthful. You can spank them, 3 seconds come back and play with them, and they'll laugh at you like you ain't just spanked them. That's why Christ said for us to be like them. Be innocent like them. Amen. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus for the remission. That word remission means forgiveness. For the forgiveness of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We need that gift. We're going to talk about the Holy Ghost one day. We still got to finish with this thing with the soul. I was just motivated to talk about this because I was getting comments telling me I'm wrong about baptism. for making, for saying that the man sprinkled with water. People told me I'm wrong. My question is, how am I wrong? What are you judging me by? What is it that you're determined that I'm wrong? Because it ain't the word of God. So are you determined because this person said this is the way it's done, and because I'm saying that's not the way it's done, you saying that I'm wrong? That's not the way to determine if I'm right or wrong. The way to determine if I'm right or wrong is to show me I'm wrong in here. That's how you tell me I'm wrong. If this says that when Christ comes back, he's coming back through the clouds, and you have me running around talking about, oh no, he told me he's going to be on Fifth Avenue. He's going to be there on Sunday by April the 1st. So all of us got to come over there to be waiting on him. The Bible says no man knoweth the day or the hour. And the Bible says that he ain't coming back on land like that no more. When he comes back, he come back through the cloud. That's what the word of God says. See, that's how you determine if I'm right or wrong, by this. That's why when I preach to you or when I teach you something, I preach to you this. I don't tell you what Father Frank is doing or what Jack is doing, or I heard Reverend Two Willie said this is how you do it. I don't go by that. I can't follow them. Why? Because Jesus said, take heed that no man deceive you. Don't you let nobody trick you. No people tricking you if they telling you that they can sprinkle water on you. It ain't in here. There's not even one example in here of somebody being sprinkled with water and was baptized. That's not even one, not even a half of one. There's actually zero examples of somebody being sprinkled with water. So if it ain't in here, why am I getting mad when somebody tells me the truth? Why? Why are you mad at me for telling you the truth? I'm telling you the truth. You know, that's the problem Jesus was having. If you read the story of Jesus, oh, you ain't Jesus. I don't know why you think you did. The Bible says to follow Christ. Bible says a Christian is somebody who follow Christ, who imitate Christ. I'm following him. Jesus says, in this world, they hated me. He said, they'll hate you too. That's what he said. I didn't say that. The Lord said that.
Coming up, scenes for part two.
You're going to be judged by this word. So if I'm going to be judged by this word, I need to know this word. And I need to live by this word. I don't need to live by this man's word. This man that's telling me that sprinkling water is on my baby, that means he's saved, he's good, all his sins is washed away. That's a lie. That's not how your sins are washed away. Baptism is not washing away your sins. That's symbolizing the death, burial, and resurrection. You confessing your sins. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, he says, if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness by confession.